Bloodhunt is a third-person free-to-play battle royale game set in the Vampire the Masquerade universe. You will battle players and AI enemies as you fight to become the last vampire standing in the old town of Brague. One small day tensions between rival vampire sects have erupted in the open conflict across the rooftops and in the streets of Brague, while vampire hunters of the Second Inquisition capitalize on the chaos in an attempt to eradicate both factions. You must rely on supernatural powers, ranged and melee weapons, and wits to dominate the night and restore the masquerade. Who is the developer and publisher of the game? They are... The game is developed and published by Shark Mob, with studios in both London and Sweden, Malmo, which were founded by veteran developers with titles such as The Division, Far Cry, Battlefield and Hitman under their belts. Bloodhunt will launch in 2021, but the release date has yet to be revealed. It will launch on Steam, no further platforms have been announced. The game is free to download and play in. In-game cosmetic items will be available for optional purchase. There will not be any pay-to-win progression mechanics. Game modes that will be available in the game are at launch with solo and three-player squad battle royale modes, and there will be such as many players playing simultaneously as 45 players to be able to complete in each game session. There will be a closed alpha playtest, and the servers will open from July 2nd to July 4th. Pre-download is available from July 1st. You are able to sign up for the closed alpha right now. Shark Mob has unveiled Bloodhunt, brand new battle royale game set in the Vampire the Masquerade universe. Bloodhunt is a game where each player is a superpowered vampire, running up walls in rain, slick, Brague night, hunting unsuspecting humans, other vampires, and anti-bloodsucker special forces unit entity. The producer described the appeal of the game as the complete freedom of movement and the tempo of gameplay combined with a refreshing urban vampire take on the churn. Within minutes, it was easy to grasp the importance of the tall buildings in Brague, the tightly knit networks of streets like a red mage, where skirmishes take place between vampires dugging in and out of the covers. Up above, players leapt around rooftops using scanned sculptures and building height variations to mask your approach or dodge a hail of gunfire. By adding verticality, the game opens up new angles over attack, adding fresh perspective to engagements, a great hook that synthesizes well with the map design and fiction. Game director Greg Hubbard explained some of the challenges of designing the city. A city map presents a lot of challenges, especially a historical European city where you spend a lot of time on rooftops. Given how high your jumps take you and how easy it is to scramble up sheer walls, you do spend a lot of time up high. We have put a ton of effort into making sure players can orient themselves, locate loot, and experience tactical variety as they move from area to area, said Hubbard. Gameplay is all about fast, fluid traversal, trying to blindside or evade enemies aloof, which is fit naturally and feel really fun and exciting in a tight vertical environment. I get frustrated in other games where I come to an obstacle that I have to navigate around, says Hubbard, and you can see why other battle royals don't offer this kind of movement. Tactical positioning is high on every player's mind when playing Warzone or Apex Legends, but Bloodhunt changes all that. Being able to climb anything in the game world and either engage or disengage in really fast, flexible ways is hugely entertaining for me. Even Bloodhunt approach to the ever-enduring circle and stable of the churn is totally different. rather than a ring, it's an umbrellous shape that clings closer to the street and rooftops, funneling vampires into harrowing contests, forcing them to fight hard. Hubbard also explained that initially people pushed back against the chains. We got feedback that the cast should be circular like every other battle royale, but eventually people started to view its irregular shape and unpredictable movement as something interesting and different. The change to the cast also comes with changes to other battle royale staples, whilst ammo, armor and guns are all looted from shops and cars on the streets, as well as from other players. Bloodhunt is also introduced the idea of feeding on certain NPCs to get the buffs to special ability recharges, damage reduction, and more. Skulking through the shadows to feed on humans you have spotted with your extra sensory vision modes is a neat touch, adding objectives beyond hunting and killing others. Binding your time to buff up is as valid as ambushing teams trying to do the same. Tougher teams of Indeed Soldier also guard guaranteed high-tar weapons and gear, and can also be fed on for buffs. But these will need a concerted team effort to take down, and the noise of conflict attracts other teams, which can be a good way of inciting conflict or setting up an ambush, as I found out in my play session. With 8 classes across 4 archetypes, Bloodhunt has a fair amount of nuance in its team composition. The more melee-oriented classes gain a long-distance shockwave and the superhero style ground-bound couplet with a powerful second jump. Elsewhere, other classes wrap the jump for a clone protection or invisibility. One particular ramp was able to send out clusters of bats to act as alert mines, a great way of doing long distance spotting or making it tougher for players to sneak up on you. Hopper tells me that these classes we draw heavily from the Vampire the Masquerade rules and lore, which is a lot of more grounded in reality than some vampire IPs, so it seems like turning the bats or mist is off the cards for the time being. So Bloodhunt is a third-person shooter battle royale free-to-play coming to PC and Steam very soon, and there's gonna be a closed alpha that you can sign up right now, and I literally like the game. It looks good and feels smooth and something like I would like to grind. I hope it's not gonna get be boring.
No other position bear.
One down.
And two more. I only have a shotgun, so I gotta go in their face. Kinda like Westy's doing. I'll follow you, Westy. Oops. I think somebody's on top of the Vandisco. I got shot from there.
Really? Yeah. I wonder if I can go and chop them up then.
Jump down, jump down. Towards you, Westy.
Towards me?
Yeah.
Yeah, you have two or three people on you.
That's fine. I'm reloading now.
Joining in a sec.
Can you...
One up on that roof over there on red.
Getting you up. There you go.
I think they're healing.
They are.
Tags?
Yeah. Jumping across.
You got guys behind you as well?
Smuff, 150.
Was one guy who jumped over onto this roof over here.
There.
On the far side over there.
Getting up, yeah.
Thank you. I'm gonna put a little you can put the put your shields on by using the G menu. That's good to know. Okay. Still on that roof over there. A little bit closer now, yeah.
Oh, I've got you covered if they push. I'm just sniping them in the head repeatedly.
We gotta move slightly in because Red Guest is also approaching.
Oh, did he hit you? Did he hit you?
Someone else hit me, yeah.
Gonna heal you up, Jack.
Thank you.
Take some time though, but we're getting there. Okay.
Got counter sniped.
So let's move. Oh!
Oh!
No! Yeah! Get out! Or kill them! I'm
down.
You.
Get down.
Nice.
Dead.
How do I heal? Is it G?
At G and use the blood bag or something.
Oh no!
Play for yourself,
no!
My speed!
No! No! I can't believe
We're fine. Oh no, the red gas. You can't regenerate in the red gas, so if you get caught by that...
Yeah, you can try.
Oh, nice.
Oh, GK.
It's gonna be close. It's gonna be close.
Oh no. No, Jack. Oh. No.
Oh.
Are you fine, Westy, or not?
I think I'm too far out. Yeah, I'm too far out. This is not gonna work. It's a cheeky sniper you had there, Jack.
No!
It was, wasn't it?
Eliminated.
That gas killed you so quick.
Yeah. It killed
me. Play second out of 13.
I mean,
not too bad.
First game on, not bad.